Welcome back to Family Recipe Ghar. Today we are going to make delicious, yummy Ragi Ladoo. Ragi basically is a type of millets that's easily available in South India, but must be available in North India as well. It is very rich in calcium, is great for the gastrointestinal tract, and generally is a cooling substance, so basically great for hot weathers. Also eaten during pregnancy for building muscles and for as a protein for muscles and bones. So we will need about 2 cups of finely crushed ragi flour. You need about 1.5 cups of jaggery. You need about 1 cup of grated coconut, about 1/4 a glass of water, and a teaspoon of cardamom powder, about 2 to 3 tablespoons of ghee, homemade ghee, to bind it. Let's start making the laddu. Place the pan with ghee on flame, low flame, so that it gets a little hot. Now, little by little, start pouring the ragi flour into this ghee. Mildly roast it till an aromatic flavor starts coming out, and then you can switch off the flame. So after about 3 to 5 minutes of roasting, we are now transferring this onto a plate so that this mixture cools down. So having set aside the ragi and the ghee roasted one mixture for cooling down, we are now going to make the rest of the laddu. Of course, you can use more ghee than we have used. We have used about 4 tablespoons. 3 to 4 tablespoons. You can use more, it will be more aromatic and yummy, of course. So now add the jaggery and the water and let that melt and form a nice thick mixture. So once the jaggery has completely dissolved in water and it starts to boil, add the grated coconut into this mixture. Adding the grated coconut into the jaggery mixture, mix it well till all the coconut incorporates the jaggery. Keep it on flame for about 2 minutes, following which the mixture will thicken this way. Gradually add the ragi powder in this that we had already cooled a little bit. Now give it a good mix so that the ragi incorporates the coconut and the jaggery in it. And we should turn the flame off at this point, otherwise the whole thing will become muggy. Add the cardamom powder into this mixture and again mix the whole ingredients together. Once it cools down a little bit, smear your hands with ghee and start molding into laddu shapes. But do not be in a hurry and put your hands into this hot mixture already. Now since this was made on flame, the shelf life is about 2 to 3 days if you have kept it outside. It can last longer if you refrigerate it. But of course it becomes a little hard if you keep it in the fridge. So it's best that you keep it out for about 2 and 3 days and completely finish it off by then. Once you've smeared your hands with ghee, start binding them into laddus in this way. Take small portions and knead them, and in your hand itself mold them into laddus. Suppose you feel that the whole mixture is not coming into a laddu shape, that enough amount of water content is not there, you can add a little milk so that it comes handy and the whole thing forms a laddu like shape. This way. So our yummy ragi laddus are ready. So if you bind them in this size, about 12 laddus can be easily made and can be, of course, will get over in 2 days. This is great for pregnant ladies or who have delivered recently, and for kids because it's very nutritious. Also for people who are craving for sweets but are still worried about weight gain or excess calorie, this is a great way to go because it's not very sweet and the calories that it generates is also very less. And ragi, the millets that is there in this, also gives a lot of calcium and can enrich your hemoglobin, and of course is a great source of good amount of protein and fiber. Have fun making this and have even more fun gobbling it up. Take care, like, subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.